Ben Carson, real quick. He gave an interview to Sally Quinn with the Washington Post the other day, talked about how he doesn't believe in a physical place called hell. He doesn't believe in the rapture. There's some other things in there that might be give evangelicals pause. What did you make of some of those comments? Did that take you aback a little bit?
No, it didn't surprise me because Ben Carson is a Seventh-day Adventist. Hmm. And so I think what is surprising is that we have so many evangelicals who believe that Ben Carson is right out of Vacation Bible School when he holds to, he's in a particular church that holds to very unorthodox doctrines. Hmm. Now, having said that, I don't think that disqualifies him from the presidency any more than I think that Mormonism disqualified Mitt Romney. Mm-hmm. One doesn't need to be someone that we would want teaching Sunday school in order to faithfully execute the office. Mm-hmm. What it does mean, though, is that I think we ought to stop trying to make our political leaders into spiritual mascots when they're not able to carry that burden and shouldn't be asked to carry that burden. Mm-hmm. And so I think of the example of Thomas Jefferson. My Baptist ancestors back in the founding era were willing to ally themselves with Thomas Jefferson, even though he was certainly not anyone that we would want teaching anything behind a pulpit. Huh. But he had a common interest in religious liberty and freedom, and they were willing to make an alliance on those issues. I think the same thing can be true for presidential candidates.